problem where we are given a binary array, that is, it contains only zeros and ones, and we have to find the index of zero that we should remove such that we get a maximum sequence of continuous ones. So just to explain the problem, we are given, let's say, an array like this, and if I replace this 0 with 1, then I will get 2 consecutive 1s. If I replace this 0 with 1s, then I will get a consecutive sequence of 1s which will be of this length. If I replace this 0 with 1, then I get a consecutive sequence of these many 1s. So I have to find that one index of 0 that if I replace with 1, I get the maximum sequence of continuous 1s. In this case, of course, it will be this 0. How do we program such that we can do that? So it is an interesting problem, and let's say we want to do it only in a single pass, so we pass through the array just once and we do it. So what do we do? We keep track of when we encountered the previous zero. That is important. So, because if I convert this zero to one, how do I figure out how many contiguous ones will I get? I can figure that out only if and I reach this zero. Then I know, okay, so previous zero was here, current zero is here, so between these two, this. Similarly, if I want to check if I replace this 0 with 1, if I replace this 0 with 1, how many 1s, what will be the length of consecutive sequence of 1s, how do I get that? Well, I need the next 0, that so which will tell me in the what are all in the right. I need the previous 0, which will tell me what all will be in the left. So I want the previous 0 and I want the next 0. But if I'm looping through the array once, then I can't, like for every array, I can't go back and forth. I can only go in one direction. So how about I keep track of a previous 0 and a previous 0 and a current 0. So when I'm at current 0, I can figure out if I replace the previous 0 with 1, what will be the number of 1s that I get from representing the previous 0, because I have the previous 0 also. So we maintain 3 or at least 2. So one is previous, and let's give it minus 1. Another is previous, which is also minus 1. So we now walk through the array for i0, i less than n, i++, if a of I is equal to 0, then also we need to keep track of two things, which is int index, call it minus 1, and int length, let's call it l, which is again minus 1. So if the index is 0, then if we have previous as well as previous, then it's an easy thing. The other corner cases will handle at the end. So that means it's neither this 0 nor this 0, it's this 0. So before this is at least the third 0. Before that we have had two more zeros. We know that. So for those cases, what we figure out is we figure out the length. So int let's call it x. So the length will be what? So this is a good example. Or even this is a good example. So we take this. So mind you, when we are at I, we are checking if we replace the previous with 1, what will be the number of total number of 1s from this previous till this I. So in this example, if I take this as the previous, this has the previous and this has the I, and I'm looking for this previous guy and see how many ones will I get. I should take a better example here with numbers, so that will make it more clear. Okay, so let's call it a 0 and then 1 1 1 and then 0 and then 1 1 1 and then 0. So and the indexes are 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. What I'm saying is my previous is 0, previous is equal to 4, and I is equal to 8. So when I'm at 8, I know that the previous and the previous is not minus 1. So if I replace previous with previous value with 1, what is the length of consecutive ones? So if I replace this with 1, I had, so number of ones between this and this is, so here between previous and previous we had, in between them we had 3 ones, which is 4 minus 0 minus 1. So we had previous minus previous minus 1 on the left side, and we had I minus previous I minus previous, which is 8 minus 4 minus 1 on the right side, and if we replace it with 1, so we get 1. This total is previous minus previous minus 1 plus previous minus previous minus 1 plus 1 minus 1 plus 1 gets cancelled. This minus 1 will move towards the end. Hey, where did I go? Previous minus 1 plus I minus previous minus 1. Some mistakes, huh? Okay, basically if you just sum all these things, previous comes, total number of ones is previous minus previous minus 1 plus I minus previous minus 1 plus 1. 1 minus 1 gets cancelled. Previous gets cancelled. So we get I minus previous minus 1, which is basically, this is I till previous, 8 minus 0 minus 1 is 7. So will that be true? From 1 to 7, all of them will be 1, which is true. So I minus previous minus 1. You can do the math, you can convince yourself how we get there. But the idea is the length that we get is I minus previous minus 1. And now, if whatever length we have saved, if this x is greater than that length, then we update that length. Now we have considered the cases where we have a good mix. Now what about the corner cases, which is you do not have so one of the cases is let's say we have so many ones, and then we have 0, and that's it, that's the entire thing. For this we won't have the two previous and previous. What do we do for that? the else part, then what are all the cases that we are missing? One of the cases that we are missing is a simple one, which is let's say the same thing. Okay, we did figure out about this, but if that is the entire length, and let's say there is one sum like that, but if we don't get another zero, and this is 9 and this is 10, and we reach the n, we reach n, and it is not, we reach n minus 1. So if I is equal to n minus 1, and this is not equal to 0, then whichever, and one more thing which is crucial is that whether we do this or not, that is fine, but we need to update previous to previous and previous to I. Okay, so this is the case where we are looking at a scenario like this. So when we were at this zero, we handled for this zero, but we did not handle for the zero before that. Again, I'm thinking so many things in my mind. There is one more thing to do. There are two things to do. To be done. One is this, and other is update the index as I. Okay. Where is the index? Did we keep index? Yeah. Okay. So for that, for this zero, we did not do anything. But we reached the end, and the end is not equal to zero. And you know what? Even if the end is zero, even if this end is zero, we did not consider what happens if I replace this zero, because I only consider what happens if it is not zero. Again, it's possible you only have one zero. Like all the cases, how do we consider? So, what about this case? We only have this one zero, and we should replace this particular zero to, so the previous and previous. The thing is, if we reach the end, can I say this? Can I ignore these conditions? These two conditions? No, because we are looking for previous. We're not looking for index equal to I here. We're looking for index equal to previous. So previous has to be there. What if previous is not there? Okay. So what if this wasn't there? And in that case, we'll have zero. Oh, come on. We'll have index as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So this guy we will not handle. The first 0 we won't handle, because, oh, okay, the first time when we come here, there is no previous, we won't handle the 0. Then we come here, we'll handle the previous 0 now. So what will be the previous 0? We have seen is it will be I minus previous minus 1, which is, in this case, we don't have a previous. Let's say the previous is minus 1. If we use that, will that still work? So 7 minus minus 1 is 7, plus 1 is 8, minus 1 is 7. So actually, it will work, right? So previous is, if you have, good. If you don't have, keep it as minus 1. No problem at all. So this isn't needed. So for the second zero onwards, we'll be able to handle the situation. So for this zero, when we are at this zero, we we look at this 0, we see what if I replace this 0 with 1. So how many 1s will we get? 4 plus 3 is 7. And the condition that we got is I, this is I, which is 7, minus previous is minus 1, 8. 7 minus minus 1 is 8, minus 1 is 7. And these many 1s I'll get, so that works. So we have handled this case. Now the cases that we have not handled is, how do we handle the 0? Because if we reach the end, that is at the end of the loop, so after the loop, maybe not even in the loop, maybe at the end of the loop, because the last, very last zero nobody has handled, the very last zero nobody has handled. So for that we check. So in this case the very last zero will be previous, so its value is previous. If you replace that with 1, you need the previous. So if, let's get x first, what is the length? Is previous or is it n minus 1? So it is n minus previous. You know what I'm getting? Let's make it simple. Let's take this case itself. Put some 0 here and then put some. Okay, let's go up. Let's take this case. So when we come to this 0, we'll handle this 0, but when we reach the end in such a scenario, we want to figure out what happens if I replace this 0 with 1. I need this index here, which is what? N. So I will be replaced by N, and everything else is still the same. So 10 minus 3 is 7, minus 1 is 6, which is correct too. So go to down, you get to N minus previous minus 1. And if this x is greater than 1, or greater than that length, then you do index is equal to previous and l is equal to x. Any case which is still left, that we have any 0 that is missing, that we haven't considered. So we consider, what about the first 0? Do we ever consider the first 0? Well, yeah, no. So for this first 0, when you go to the second 0, we consider. If there is no second 0, then it is actually the last 0. If it is the last 0, it will be considered in that remaining case. So yes, it should handle everything. Now let's get rid of all those things, or let's keep it, you know, why not keep it. Okay, now when we do all these things, we have to return an index which is idx. Let's try and test it now. Run the code, fix the compilation. Alrighty, what are the compilation errors? I less than n, he doesn't know what n is, let's define n. I don't know what n is, how will he know? Alrighty, now you should know n. Running, it says index to be replaced as 7. Let's see, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Alright, this 0, he says I want to replace this 0, he will get this length, which is the right answer, because if you replace this 0, you will get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 ones, If you replace this 0, you get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 ones. So he's done the right thing. Just look at the code again. It's basically, instead of taking a 0, for every 0 going back and forth looking at the number of ones, which will like increase the complexity to n square, we walk through the array, but we keep track of previous as well as previous, and we round current. We try to update what will happen if we replace the previous with one, and that's the code. And we try to took all the cases. So in the loop, we figured out that previous if it's previous is not there, but the previous is there, even that is enough. So from starting from the second zero onwards, we can update the values for the all the zeros. But what if there is only one zero, and what about the last zero? For both cases, whether when there is only one zero, or and also to handle the last zero, after the loop we again do the check for that particular zero, and we update the length, we update the index, and all those things. If you want to check the code out, you can go to this link and check the code. Alrighty, that's all today.